Hello, I'm Matt Gill from House.com. This is a 2020 Salomon Huck Knife, and this is the Huck Knife Pro. And I'm gonna show you their similarities and their differences. Both of these boards absolutely slay. I'm gonna kind of walk you through each of the decks and their benefits, maybe some of their shortcomings, show what is similar, show what is different, and hopefully by the end of the video, you'll know which board is gonna be best for you. First, as I kind of get into these, I really like the Huck Knife series. I'm really glad that they added in the Huck Knife Pro, of course. They both have great graphics, and they're awesome for park riding. You can even kind of take them into the all-mountain freestyle category if you'd like to. Just to kind of give you a broad overview of both boards first, the regular Huck Knife is well known for great pop and, of course, agility. And it's a little bit more out of these two boards designed for jibbing. However, it still jumps really well. Whereas the Huck Knife Pro is well known for its power and its stability. It's a little bit better for jumping than the Huck Knife, but it still can be jibbed too. Let's get to their similarities. There's actually a lot of them. Both of them share the overall same shape. This is a true twin style board. They both have centered styled stances and a quad camber profile shape, which is pretty cool. The quad camber is basically a full camber profile. It does have a little bit of rocker on those contact points. You just kind of raise them up to make them a little more catch free, along with the 360 wrap standard steel edge with a freestyle edge bevel. It makes it a little less catchy. But the great part about the quad camber in the Huck Knife and the Huck Knife Pro is that they have variable shapes in the radius of the camber. Between the feet, the board has a more mellow arc. It's a larger radius, whereas from underneath each foot to the contact point, the board has a more drastic and sharp, smaller radius style camber shape. And what that does is allows for there to be tons of energy in the pop on both the nose and the tail. And that's a couple of great benefits of these being park boards. But when you're still carving them, it's not gonna, they're not gonna be overly aggressive and like pop you like out of a turn where you can't control it. That's something I really like. They both also feature something called Popsure Core Profiling. Both boards have a thick wood core underneath each foot and in the direct center of the board that allows for better energy transfer right to the edge. And then thinner sections of that wood core on the medial side of where the bindings rest. And the idea behind that is that Salomon wanted to provide a nice platform to be pressed with on the nose and tail so you don't fold over the top of it, but have the flex point be on the medial side to lift up the board there instead of in front of your front foot, which is great. Both bases are centered. This is a centered EG style base. They'll both absorb lots of wax, but you need to keep them maintained throughout the season, of course. Centered bases will ride faster than extruded bases unless they're not waxed. So keep them waxed up. And they both feature the EQ Rad side cut radius. Basically, three sections that are flat along a side cut radius. And the idea behind that is that when you are tracking straight off a jump or off a jib, if you have a little bit of tilt with the board, that centered flat section will help you to go straight instead of veer off to either the right or the left. Those are the main similarities of the board. There's actually quite a few of them. The biggest differences are gonna be the flex and some additional laminates and how they feel. The feel of both of these boards is gonna be just a little bit different. The Huck Knife has a flex and feel of a 5, so right about average, not too stiff, of course, not too soft. And whereas the Huck Knife Pro has a feel of a 6, and that's because of those additional laminates. Now there's three main laminates that the Huck Knife Pro has. It features Booster. That's kind of a combination with the Popsure kind of profile. You can kind of see that through the tail here. There's four strips of carbon in three sections on each, the nose and the tail. All three kind of radiate from this starting point. The first section runs right down the center of the board. and then to each contact point. And that provides energy right to those contact points, so it's more stable at high speeds. And then it also provides a little bit more energy in that platform of that tail for higher ollie snap in combination with that quad camber profile shape. Another reason that I really enjoy that booster is that if you land a little bit off axis, and then a little tail or nose heavy, if you're hitting a huge booter, is that that more stable platform will help you to stand up on it instead of loop and wash out, which is great. The second thing in the laminate of the Huckneck Pro is the full gunslinger style sidewall. It's rubber that's sandwiching carbon. The rubber helps to absorb negative vibrations and help to dampen the ride. And the carbon, of course, adds additional pop. And then there's lastly the damplifier that's found in both the nose and the tail, a triangle style shape that's actually honeycomb that helps to reduce swing weight in both the nose and the tail. The idea behind that is basically having more of the center of mass toward, or more of the mass towards the center of the board, allowing you to spin faster because you won't have to swing as much weight around on both the nose and the tail because of the damplifier. And that's really great. Now, the Huck Knife doesn't feature those additional laminates, but it does feature what's called a slingshot in the side walls. It's similar to the Gun Slinger, but the side walls have a very short style section where the bindings rest with that rubber and with that carbon. So it's gonna be a little bit more soft within between the feet, and of course a little bit more soft on the nose and tail because it doesn't have that booster carbon overlays that the Huck Knife Pro has. Now with the Huck Knife, there's an Aspen Select style wood core, tip to tail, rail to rail wood core that's hand selected. But it's not gonna be as lightweight as what you'll find in the Huck Knife Pro, because the Huck Knife Pro has what's called the Ghost Green. Now the Ghost Green core is a combination of the aspen that you'll find in the Huck Knife, but it does have Polonia style strips in it to keep it more lightweight. Those are the big differences. The Huck Knife is gonna be more pliable, easy to flex and press out than what you find in the Huck Knife Pro. This will be a good jumper, but it's gonna be a little bit better for jibbing of the two. And the Huck Knife Pro will be a little bit better for jumping than jibbing. But for the most part, within the full spectrum of boards from Salomon, the Huck Knife is, you know, a little bit more on the aggressive side of freestyle boards, even though the Huck Knife is just regular. The regular Huck Knife is just a feel and flex of a 5, and this one's a 6. It's quite a bit stiffer than most boards like the 6-piece, the Sight, Pulse, you know, et cetera, et cetera. Great decks, of course, but those are the big differences. Those are the big similarities. Again, there's gonna be a lot more power and stability found in the Huck Knife Pro. Great for jumping. And there's gonna be a lot of pop and agility. You can torsionally flex the regular Huck Knife a lot more. It's a little bit more beneficial for jibbing. Great decks that you can both check out at thehouse.com right now by selecting the links below in the description. Leave a comment or question, let me know what you think, and hopefully see you guys on snow. Peace.